right. So these speed painting I've been doing, it's pretty fun, but you know, I can't really use them for anything else, just for practice. These ones I sort of can. I would have to change a lot of the features on them. So we're rendering this one today, which was for my challenge. So this was actually in the fourth sketch that I did. No, I think I use something like this for prints or something. We'll see how it goes though. So I have to clean it up a little bit more. Unfortunately, I merged the sketch with the good line art. Which was my mistake. We'll try to clean it up, I guess. Oops. Oops. That looks better when it fits back there. It's like a little bit off. Okay. Okay, let's paint this. It's a bit dark. Okay, seems like I have to go back and forth. Oops, wrong layer. All right, so we'll start rendering. We'll hide this. Thank you. I might do some just simple rendering today, and then we'll move on to our next piece. Zoom levels this, we'll go to 2 so we can really control the line strokes. So turn this on, so it's pretty good for line weights, tapering off anyways. Yo, hey, the unsanctioned. How's it going, man? Whew, how goes your streams? You look like you're kicking up a notch. Thanks for the biddies. Always appreciate it, man. Bye. Thanks for the support. Hope you're doing well. Have a good night, brother. You're killing it as always. Thank you. So are you, man. I like your streams. Very lively. What, 80%? It's always a grind. It's okay, it's like when I'm drawing I should be streaming anyways, so it doesn't make sense to draw and not stream almost. If I can, I will. Let's do a 10 brush. Whoops. See that little like zigzags here? I don't know if that's actually normal. Let's put like this thing and see if that helps. Nope. How about flow? Supposed to be like a stabilization thing. Yeah, the only way to get rid of that for me anyways, it's zooming in. Look how smooth it is. Even if I go slow, there's no ripples, not as much. Actually, should look up on how to make the lines more steady in Photoshop. Shit. Oh man, I can't study yet. It's like way off. I gotta go slow. Look at all the riffles here. Undo. Zoom. More stable on 200%. Oh my god, I think it's my elbow. What's happening? I can't hit this line. It's the way I'm sitting, probably. I need to sketch more again. I can't hit these lines. I know I can rotate, but I like to control the way my arm moves in any direction. Oh, I want. This line is wrong. Bring it back up, down, sorry. Man, I should go back to sketching. My lines are horrible right now. I guess I'll go back to all my sketches that I've done for that challenge and just go over with the fine lines. So this actually will improve my line practice. Oops. And there you go. trying to go lighter, and so I can have that bit of a tapering of my breast strokes. Looks kind of cool. One of the things that people said, like, hold your pencil a bit further away. I'm on a weird angle. There we go. Maybe this level is better. Ah, see, I got more flow. So got some jitter. Oh, this is better. Yeah, sometimes it's about positioning yourself. Now my hand's like totally unrestrained. I think the desk was too high. So I've got one of those desks that's adjustable of height. So I'm sitting rather higher up. So, yeah. Now that my elbow can, it's not touching anything. It's actually levitating. Way better. I mean, when I got my new equipment, everything kind of changed, even like the level of the desk, because the positioning of the drawing tablet is actually inside my folding drawer now instead of outside the desk. So I think I've gotten used to when the tablet was on the desk, not in the drawer. It's good that it's in the drawer now because it's it protects the tablet from dust and anything that spills. And if I just need the keyboard and I don't need to access the drawing tablet, I kind of like that setup. Try to fix this one. It's rather thin in lines. And kind of wobbly. Oh, it's from the other one. Let's try to really experiment how do people really render so, like, you know, like airbrush so evenly. This is like smooth as heck. I mean, some don't even do that. They like, you can see the brush stroke, and on some parts is like so airbrush, and then some parts are like, you can see the brush strokes so much, and it doesn't affect the piece. So I tend to like work from a very low opacity when it comes to rendering, and then work your way up. I was thinking doing something cool with the hair. I do need to make it so I can select them easier. God, that was hurting my eyes. I forgot to do change it to gray. Why is it so bright? Oh wow, I'm seeing green on the gray background. Oh jeez, might have to stop, rest my eyes or something. I think it was all that white. Here, let's make it more pink. Let's see. Maybe 20%. All right, save. All right, I'm gonna take off, maybe put my head down. Yeah, I was gonna do something I've seen before and I kinda wanna try it out, on her hair. I'm not sure about the purse. Yeah. We'll see from for next time. I'll see you guys next week. Peace out.